And finally, it's long been a conventional fact of life in the workplace. Women are paid less than men for the same work, on average earning about 80 cents on the dollar. But a brand new analysis of census data stands that convention on its head for some women. Which ones? Here's Sharon Alfonsi.
Danielle Fenoy is one of New York's top designers. And like many young women across the country, she now earns more than many of her male counterparts.
People take you seriously when you're expensive. So I think that's part of the reason why I charge what I charge.
She's not alone. On average, women are now making 8% more than men.
I think that's fantastic. It gives me actually a little more encouragement to raise my prices even more.
But there is one caveat, and it's a big one.
Are you married?
No.
Do you have children?
No.
It turns out those women making more money, they're unmarried. They don't have little ones at home, and they're all under the age of 30. So for the rest of us, we still have some hurdles.
Men tend to work more hours than women. Women tend to take time off for childbirth or for taking care of potentially parents.
But why the sudden reversal with young women? Well, the answer can be found in any college classroom. For every two guys who graduate college today, three women do. And we know college graduates earn almost $30,000 more than high school graduates. And in some cities, young women aren't just earning more than the guys, they're clobbering them, earning 12% more than men in L.A., 14% more in Raleigh and Charlotte. And in New York, women are making 17% more than men. For thousands of young women, it is a reason to celebrate, and they'll have no problem picking up the tab. Sharon Alfonsi, ABC News, New York.
One postcard from a changing world.